Hello everyone, and in this video we will see what is Microsoft Power Platform, which is a part of our free Microsoft Power Platform Tutorials for Beginners video series, which is a series of 9 videos where we will learn basic introduction about what is Microsoft Power Platform and its related components. So as far as this video is concerned, we will learn what is Microsoft Power Platform in nutshell. So ladies and gentlemen, my name is Abhishek Doria and you are watching Dynamix Academy YouTube channel. So let's get started. Subscribe to Dynamix Academy and press the bell icon on your YouTube app to never miss a video from Dynamix Academy. So friends, let us now understand what is Power Platform. As you might have already heard, that it is one of the trending and hottest technology which is booming in the market today. To understand Power Platform in context, it is a full-fledged service or the group of products which Microsoft provides for all the organizations to measure, act, and automate some of their existing business processes to drive better business outcomes. And the end goal of Microsoft is to deliver more power into non-technical or non-developers community so that even they can participate in making their day-to-day lives easier and they can achieve more in their day-to-day activities. So if they are able to achieve more, ultimately they will be able to drive their businesses efficiently and effectively, which will at the end of the day help their organizations to achieve more and to do more. So having said that, let us now understand what is Power Platform. The Power Platform is a low-code platform that enables organizations to analyze their data, act on it through applications, and automate their business processes. It allows everyone from a professional developer to frontline worker to participate in driving better business outcomes by building apps. So this is the core principle or core definition of Power Platform, where this platform enables everyone, not only the professional developers, but even a frontline worker. He may be working in an HR team or a finance or an accounting team, but still with very limited coding knowledge, they'll be able to build applications and automate their day-to-day business processes. So having said that, Power Platform is a collecting term used for following 4 Microsoft products, which are Power BI, Power Apps, Power Automate, which was previously called as Microsoft Flows, but now it is rebranded as Power Automate. And lastly, the newest addition to Power Platform family is Power Virtual Agents. We are going to cover each of these 4 products and along with this, the entire architecture and other supporting components of Power Platform in detail per video into this course. So let us now understand the core Microsoft Power Platform architecture. You can visualize it not only as 4 different products, but how they integrate well together and how they combine and give you the abilities and functionalities that you need to do your day-to-day task in much more easier and sophisticated manner. First of all, what is Power BI? Power BI is a business analytics tool which you can leverage to build more effective and powerful reports and dashboards, which you can use within your organization as well as you will be able to share outside your organization, and it will work seamlessly across the platform and across the devices. So once you have the data gathered at one centralized place, you will be able to make certain decisions and you will be able to summarize the day-to-day business organization's data in an effective manner. So after that, you might want to act on those data. So how you will be able to act on those data? With the help of another component or another product called Power Apps. So Microsoft Power Apps is an application development tool, which is again a low-code, no-code application development tool through which you will be able to build modern and sophisticated mobile applications. So you do not need to be an hardcore professional developer to start building the app. Those are simple application building tool. If you are able to use Excels and macros, then you are more than good enough to start building your apps in Power Apps. Again, those applications will be working seamlessly across the platform, be it Android, iOS or Windows applications, or across the devices as well as like phones, mobiles, tablets or Windows applications as well. So do not have to worry about the end product. You just need to apply your thought process in building your applications, your day-to-day business scenarios, how you want to build application around that. At the same time, the next product is Power Automate. You can do and you will be able to achieve the process automation with the help of Power Automate. This is nothing but the robotic process automation tools. Earlier it was known as Microsoft Flows. You will be able to automate most of your day-to-day repetitive tasks that you are doing manually. With the help of Power Automate, you will be able to automate many of your repetitive tasks very easily. Once again, you do not need to be hardcore professional developers for using this tool. And lastly, the very latest and the newest addition to Power Platform family is Power Virtual Agents. These are nothing but the intelligent virtual agents or intelligent virtual chatbots that you want to leverage to enhance your customer's experience while they are interacting with your customer service. Whenever they are facing any problems or they have some concerns or inquiries, if you want to guide them to a specific process in case of some of your repetitive business case scenarios, then you will be able to use these Power Virtual Agents. So based on the interaction, you will be able to drive them to a specific process, or even if they wanted some human interaction, then you will be able to translate all of the existing conversation with a human chat box as well. And the traditional bot framework is now known as Power Virtual Agents within Microsoft Power Platform. So these were the key four products that you will be interacting or leveraging while working with Microsoft Power Platform. But this is not the end of it. Let us now understand how these products work seamlessly across the platform and how you are able to connect to a different set of external systems as well by understanding first what is common data service. So as we all know that whenever you are working with a business application, you might need to store your data into some or the other form of a database. In case of Power Platform, you are using common data service. So common data service is nothing but is a set of standard entities and attributes that has been created by Microsoft through its decades knowledge of data and attributes that you might want to utilize. So there are some set of default standard entities that will be available for you the moment you subscribe to Power Platform. So those standard out-of-the-box available entities are stored within common data service. And not only that, you will be able to create new entities and attributes as per your requirement. If the out-of-the-box entities are not sufficient for you, you will be able to control the access, as well as those newly created entities will be available across your applications, not only the Power Platform applications, but even the external systems like Dynamix 365 or even your custom applications as well. So common data service is nothing but your common data repository where your actual data is getting stored. Having seen that, let us now understand how you are able to connect to external systems with your Power Platform. So that becomes possible with the help of data connectors or Microsoft Power Platform connectors. So there are existing more than 300 plus out-of-the-box default connectors for you to start using them to connect to any of the external services like YouTube, Facebook, MailChimp, and you name it. They already have some or the other form of default data connectors. But let's say still, if you do not find the intended data connector for your custom application, then you can build your own custom data connectors that will be easily integrated with Power Platform, and you will be able to use them in your custom scenarios as well. So having seen that, let us now understand one of the new addition to this Power Platform apart from virtual agents is Power Apps Portals. If you are coming from a Dynamics CRM background, then you might be already knowing that you already get in Dynamics 365 portal subscription whenever you subscribe to a Dynamics 365 cloud. So the same thing is now being part of Power Platform as well. By the way, if you don't know what are portals are a means by which you will be able to give power, or you will be allowing your external users who are not part of your subscription, who are not your internal users, you will be able to give some sort of access to your data which is stored within your Dynamics 365 or Microsoft Power Platform. So it's not just that traditional CRM portals are moved to Power Apps Portals, but they have added new features as well. So we'll cover in detail when we are learning more about portals in our upcoming video. And lastly, this is not all. You will be able to build more intelligent and smarter application with the help of Microsoft AI Builder. So you can leverage the capabilities and benefits of artificial intelligence with the help of Microsoft AI Builder. So till now, if you want to utilize or if you want to perform any source of AI within your application, then you must have a data science background. Either you must be a data scientist or you must be a data miner as well. But that is not the requirement for using Microsoft AI Builder. Once again, I'm reiterating that even Microsoft AI Builder is a simple plug and play sort of functionality. You will be able to simply use the capabilities and drive better business outcomes with the help of Microsoft AI Builder without having any coding knowledge. You just need to apply the right data model to your business scenario and you will be able to achieve the AI capabilities within your apps, AI automation processes as well. Having said that, this is a nutshell of what is Power Platform and its core components. So we are going to cover in detail each of these components into our upcoming next videos. So on that note, I will wind this video and. So if you have learned something new out of this video, then please like, share and subscribe to Dynamix Academy. And also press the bell icon so that you will never miss any update whenever we release a new video to our Dynamix Academy YouTube channel. And on that note, I end this video and take your leave. Hope to see you all in the next video. Till then, bye-bye and take care. And once again, thank you for your time.